In African Union passport.
African Union passport.
Yes, but this same African Union passport, you know, I'm sorry, you know, since we're all talking very openly, but I was invited by the president of Angola to come and, you know, see him. And, you know, I had to go. Normally, I don't travel much during fasting period, but I went. And when I went there, I had to be given a visa on African Union passport.
Maybe there is fees for the visa?
No.
There's no fees?
It's not about fees. That, when you say African Union passport, it means that you should
get some money
everywhere.
No.
Free of charge.
I thought that was the agreement.
Yes. Okay. So I had to apply for visa. And intentionally, when I applied for the visa, I also applied on African Union passport, and I gave them that one to sample it.
Hi, outliers. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am the Pisayo, and I'm a travel and lifestyle brand. So you know how it is. You know what this video is about already. So I'm going to be giving you a few travel and education about the African Union pass. So this was launched in July 2016 in Kigali, but I recently got to know about 2018, like towards the ending of 2018, mostly when we came up with a new passport that was supposed to about Nigerian passport that was supposed to have over 90 pages or something like that. Anyways, since it came out, I don't know any civilian, so to say, that actually has it. I don't know a friend that has it, except for top officials. So before we proceed, you should know that there are three types of African Union passport. There's the ordinary one for citizens like myself and yourself, which is about 32 pages long and is valid for 5 years. And there's the one for officials, like government officials and all that, like president, governors and all of them. Does it include governors? But I know it's basically for officials. And then there are diplomats. There's African Union for diplomats. So it happens that Dangote also was given an African Union passport. Do you have to pay for it? Well, I according to what you said in this video, you didn't pay for it. Take a look.
My passports, I carry 6 to 7 passports because of visas. Okay, and even though I'm an investor, but I need visas in almost 38 countries out of 55 or so. So now they have issued us with the African Union passport. About a few of us, we've gotten the first.
Three of us.
Maybe three.
How much did I have to pay for that?
No, I didn't pay anything.
Come on,
No.
But look, I mean, I haven't got one. I mean, I support African
you didn't
Union.
Apply.
They didn't give me one. You must have paid something for those guys.
No. We got it. It is in Addis Ababa at the African Union. So I've got one.
So he didn't pay for the video. Uncle Mo is so funny. I don't know if I'm allowed to call him Uncle Mo, but the man is hilarious. Like, I really enjoyed this interview, right? And anyways, so going back to the point of paying, whenever you're asking for a passport, whenever you want a passport, of course you pay, you apply for it, but he didn't have to pay. Now that he has one, the issue is he's not able to travel to all African countries with the African Union. The idea of having an African Union passport is to travel to all African countries with the passport. But no, that's not what's happening. So I'm going to listen to this interview with Uncle Mo and Uncle Dangote. I'm going to listen to this interview. I basically took a step further to research more to understand why this is happening, why we will have an African Union passport and still be stopped. Like, you know how you have a West African passport? We Nigerians, we have West African passports, meaning that we can travel within West Africa without getting visas, like without having to apply for visa. And some other African countries, we have over 54 countries in Africa, right? And the same goes with America. You can travel like anywhere with your American passport. You can even go to London, right? Even the same thing goes with the London or Europe, European passport. Now, back to African Union passport, you get the idea of why this is supposed to give you ease of travel, supposed to further enhance trade within the continent. So many possibilities and so many advantages to this, but still, we are not able to use it for what it was created for. You went to Angola, it was still made to apply for visa and all that kind of fun stuff. Anyways, after doing more research, I found out that only 23 countries, under Euronews, only 23 countries have signed to be a part of this program. Only 23 countries have signed to be a part of this program. So, and we have over 54 countries, like I said. So, of course, There's still a lot of gap to be filled. There's still a lot more to be done. I'm like, okay, why now Angola? And the other countries, I'm not sure what other countries are yet to sign. I will put them in the description if you really want to know. They'll be in the description. So yeah, that's like the major reason that I'm like, nah, it shouldn't be so. Now, people or some countries are on the edge because of the security, like the security stakes that comes with allowing ease of travel. Now, listen to what Ongwe Dangote had to say about this.
We need political will to be able to implement most of these things that we're signing. And, you know, I think in Africa, if you will allow British, European, Americans to get in there on visa, having visa on arrival, you should allow all Africans to get in there with no visas. You know, and I keep telling them, I was on a panel with the Prime Minister of Mali. And I asked him, I said, Mr. Prime Minister, the people who are causing trouble in the other part of your country, did they come through the airports?
No.
No, those guys, they don't need a visa.
Boko Haram, that's exactly.
They don't need a visa, you know, so whether you give them, so, you know, it's better you go and concentrate on
you
the trouble.
Go from some the world, people, exactly, you go,
they
just
go through with their tanks.
5 kilometers from the airport
yes,
to cross.
Yes, with their tanks, and they come into the cities with no, So that's the,
One thing before.
That is so hilarious. Like, that made me laugh so hard. Like, it made a lot of sense. Like, you cannot stop all this eventually. Those people will always find their way in. The people, there's still high rate of crime in America, for example. There's crime in every country. So if you are thinking of, I really don't know why other countries are yet to join this opportunity. Like, this is great. This is great for us travelers. This is great for citizens. This is awesome. It's about time we come together and do something in unity. This has been launched in 2016, 2017, 2018, 2019. 3 years far. Or not all the countries are still on board. Bob, Kilo Day, This will help your economy. This will help our economy. This will help the African economy to ease trade to start with. Because this particular video, I will leave the link for this video so you guys can go and watch it. This video will open my mind into the world of manufacturing, distribution of goods and all from different countries. I'm like, why? People just want to frustrate you in so many ways. Like, you know, like, doing business takes the grace of God, you know. So I really enjoyed the video. You guys can learn more from watching the video. So that's a quick review from me. I have nothing more to say but to say that. And do you see the rhyming? That was not so much of a rhyming. But really say that, yo, we are one Africa. Please, all African countries, come on board. Let's do this. Let's move the Africa forward. We should be partners. We should, I mean, I know that there are some people really taking their steps to help Africa grow. So let's do more of that. And for those who do not know the reason why that was done, or do not know about the African Union passport, I hope this video has been some help to you in some way or the other, you know. Yeah, and if you like my beautiful face, please subscribe to this channel. Like this video if you did enjoy it. And if it was of some value to you, please share with your family and friends. Let them also learn, let them know more. And yeah, if you have any questions for me, I'll be happy to answer them. Leave your comments and your questions in the comment section below. Till next time, which is tomorrow. For those who don't know, I am doing a marathon video. I'm doing a marathon video, basically shooting videos throughout the month of May. I think I'm on my 7th or 8th day. I don't know what day it is. I don't know. You guys go and check the link here. I'll put links of my previous videos. I'm on my 7th or 8th day, and we have like many more days to go, which is like 16 or I don't know, many more days to go anyways. Yeah, we're only going to be making videos on weekdays, meaning weekends you will not find me on this channel. I'll be resting, I'll be doing something with my life that does not involve working. I hope. I only hope, because I say this, but sometimes I still do work. Anyways, guys, it's been awesome. It's been real. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you tomorrow. Till next time, do not forget to stay awesome, stay inspired. Peace.